So, what's up guys, how do you do? Welcome to Session Program Users TV. We're looking at a hello world in Xamarin Android. We're going to be covering a lot of Xamarin Android, of course with C Sharp. So this is a hello world. We're showing a simple dialogue, as you can see, with some text right here, the title as well as the message. Okay, so yeah, welcome. This is our first starter tutorial, how to work with a simple alert dialog. Let's get started. So our very first step is actually to create our Android Xamarin Android project. I'm using Visual Studio 2013. So of course, go ahead. I'm assuming that you've already installed the Xamarin. So go choose the Android, then come choose right here. Of course, the blank project. We're going to create our application from a blank project. Then of course you choose the directory where you're going to have location for your project. So choose the blank app, then click OK to create our project. So let's start with the clean slate. So what we're going to do first, main activity.cs. This right here is our main activity. Now first and foremost, we need to go of course to our main.xml. Let's proceed over to the main.xml, the code, okay, in our XML. Now you can see I'm having my top root, okay, my root tag as the relative layout, match parent for both layout width as well as the layout height. Now we also have the text view. Now this text view is going to be our header view, okay, so you guys saw it when you run the project. Then we have the button right here. When this is a show button, when this button is clicked, it's when we're going to show our dialogue. Now having done that one, let's come to our main activity.cs. First, you're going to specify the namespace. Classes normally do reside in namespaces in C#. So we have right here our namespace. Then these are going to be our imports, android.app, android.widget, and android.os. Then we'll come create a class that you are calling main activity. It's a public class. We're going to make this class derive from the android.app.activity. That will turn this class into an activity. Therefore, we're going to need to register it, of course, in our Android manifest.xml. So we come and have right here activity. Now, this is the label that we're going to show. Okay, we decorate our activity with this one label. Then the main launcher, yeah, this is our launch activity. And then the icon. Now, the icon is actually located in the drawable folder. Then, once we have that one, we're going to have a button as a private, as an instance field to this particular class, button show button. Then we're going to have a method that will create for us as well as display our alert dialog. So we come and have this one. First, we're going to instantiate the alert dialog.builder. So we come alert dialog.builder, my builder equal to new alert dialog.builder. We pass in this, okay, which is actually the context given that you're inside the main activity. Now this will give us alert dialog.builder instance. By the builder is actually a class that is defined inside the alert dialog. That's why you are referencing it. We're going to use it first to set our title. So my builder.setTitle, resource.string.title. Clearly you can see that you are referencing of course our title from the resources. So if we come to these values, you can see this resources.xml right here. So if I come to it, you can see this is my resources.xml. Of course, go ahead, add these ones. First, add the title. We're registering the title and then the message, okay? Normally, it's a better approach to, instead of hard coding values into the code, to put them in the strings.xml. Therefore, if your application is actually being translated in other languages, those particular strings can be translated as well. So, resource.string.title. Then resource.string.message as well. Well, having done that one, we're going to create our alert dialog. So alert dialog, we use the alert dialog.builder instance to create the alert dialog. So my builder.create, this will create for us the alert dialog. Then once we have the alert dialog, we just show it by invoking the show method. So having done that one, we're going to come and then handle the onCreate callback for our activity. When this activity is created, then this callback will get traced. onCreate is taking in a bundle object. Now that bundle will be passed to the onCreate method of the base class. The base class is the android.app.activity. Next, we're going to come and then set our content view. So set content view resource.layout.main. Now this is basically what you are doing right here. This main.xml file will get inflated inside this method as the view for our activity. Then we reference our show button, then listen to its click events, and then when clicked, this is what we're going to do. So this event handler that you've registered, when it's clicked, we're going to do this one. We're going to invoke the display dialog method. So that's it. That's all we need to do. Let's run the project. And definitely if we run the project, this is what we are getting right here. You can see we have our nice dialog, simple thanks tips, and then we show the message. So this is it, guys. This is what we're going to we've looked at. Now we're going to have more examples like this one, so you guys better stay tuned by subscribing to our channel, Programming Users TV. Otherwise, like the video, share it, and take care. I'll catch you in the next class.